chance whatsoever of getting out of this game alive and avoiding the bottom half of the bracket in the main event. Just a reminder, the loser goes to best of ones in the lower bracket straight away. The winner will continue on with Evil Geniuses into the upper bracket at the main event.
By the way, Knoxville just slipped me a note saying 643 GPM at 10 minutes on G. Previous record was 630 at 10 minutes, and then the second highest was 598, and third highest was Dendy, without giving a number. But
that's fine. Dendy gets in all the records he's allowed. So
what's crazy,
so that was the best GPM
at 10 minutes of 10 all minutes. Time on Lena. But the crazy thing is, this was at 10 minutes. 1 minute later, it was 100 higher. So at 11 minutes, it's got to be way beyond the record. But still, congrats to G on a record that's probably not getting next to.
In other news, on the other stream, there was a Broodmother versus a Luna. No, it's four.
It's four.
But a much better draft
bristle into it or not?
Doubtful. Anyways, that's pretty scary. Slot our first pick again for Virtus Pro, and at least newbie, they can pick up, like, Gyro, I would say, like, some like, comfort pick for them.
Bane?
Bane. Oh, what the hell? Now they go for
Virtus Pro's turn to pick. Gyro Kata! Virtus Pro's turn to ban.
What do you think about the first phase Breaker ban?
Breaker was a big problem for them.
But wasn't that because of their draft against Breaker, rather than Breaker just being a sick first phase pick?
Well, it was any hero that can just tower dive them and force a fight.
Well, they chose to ban Breaker over Slaughter.
Right.
Yeah, but he poses such a huge threat to the mid laner as well, and there's really no other hero that can do it the same way.
Slaughter is close.
Slaughter's pretty close.
He's kind of close.
But you generally don't play in position 4.
Yeah.
Most teams play 3 or 1.
And since Bounty Hunter has fallen out of favor,
it's banning Lena too, man.
Well, they do have the Darkseid pick now, so there's no reason to ban out the Brood as of yet.
Yeah. Banning Lena Quap is... It's pretty good if you want to pick a greedier safe lane, but Shadow Fiend's already out.
So, correct me if I'm wrong, Windranger wasn't banned the last time either.
Nope. To my knowledge.
Was, of course, an early Shadow Fiend pickup from newbie, so they didn't need it.
What good mid laners remain that have synergy with Darkseer? I'm thinking either melee mid laners with Iron Shell or something that uses Vacuum very well.
Ember Spirit,
Ember Spirit remains. He's not good against Slaughter Gyro, though. It's a pretty bad matchup.
He can be a position 1, though.
Yeah. But for mid?
Mid?
The Quap banned by VP. I think that was a good choice.
So, newbie also removed Rubick last time round. And Queen of Pain, and they've picked AA. So that was three of their bans.
There's still Wyvern available.
Yeah,
both teams, I think it's still working.
Oh, they ban Windranger too. Okay, I think they're thinking Alchemist here, perhaps.
There's the Rubick.
For mid.
Yeah.
I don't think, once again, it's not very good against Slaughter Gyro, but then again, what is good against Slaughter Gyro right now?
I don't
now?
Know, I'd love to see a Spectre pickup. Let's go for it.
Yeah, that's true.
Let's do it,
Howl. Always very good on that.
Yeah.
But then again, it's not a very good Spectre
game. They usually do it with Lich, though.
Yeah.
They don't pick the Spectre that often without the Lich.
So Rubick is a great pick against Slaughter, though, I gotta say. It's very good, you run in, it's very telegraphed when you engage, it's very easy for Rubick to counterplay, and good steals too. Amplify Damage is an incredible spell steal. Sprint is good too.
Is that the Ring Crush?
Crush is very situational. You obviously need to have a way of getting into the face of the enemy. When you have a Blink, it's great though.
You use Telekinesis and put them to you.
And then Crush.
It's good on one hero.
So last time round,
vacuum
we
into
had
the stolen crush.
A Spirit Breaker. This time round, we have a Visage in three.
Here's a treat.
Do you think VP are considering going for their Drow pick as well with this?
That could be a very light
Drow.
Or a mid Gyro.
There are no mid Domineers left, are there? Viper, they could ban that fifth. Or they could mid Gyro. And it's Juggernaut. I actually think Jugger is a pretty decent choice here.
It's one of Hal's better heroes. A lot of physical damage coming out, though. I don't know if they have the armor to deal with the Slaughter plus Visage. They could easily pair it with a Ventral Spear if they wanted to do, but with the Gyro, it's unlikely.
Oh, I really like Venge, actually, against Jugger. It's a good way of catching him again when he tries to spin disengage.
TA is an option for the minus armor synergy now that Shadow Fiend is banned out, now that Windranger is out.
And they do have one of the best TA players as well.
Yeah, but it's versus a Jug and Darkseer and Ice Blast. I think all of those are just like really good at removing Refraction.
Both teams actually have great TA counters. I don't think it's going to get picked here.
What other minus armor heroes are there? I guess even just Slaughter Art Visage is good enough on its own. You can just go for a normal mid laner.
Dazzle?
Dazzle, I don't know if it's aggressive enough. They don't really have that many other heroes to run around with Slaughter, because Visage, you generally sit in lane. I talked to Fogged, he said, if you rotate as Visage, you're playing it wrong. I was like, oh, okay. I told him Visage was one of my worst heroes, and then that's the piece of advice he gave me. So apparently Visages are supposed to just sit in lane and get level 6 and start crushing people.
Skywrath Mage. Okay.
You think it's going to be Nerubian Weaver? There's very little counters against it on newbie's side right now. We've seen the Nerubian Weaver being picked up twice by Virtus Pro.
Are we looking for a G hero?
Yeah, supposedly.
Probably. Now there's the Ember ban as well. They could also pull out their G Silencer here, actually. It's pretty good against the newbie lineup. It has really good physical damage output together with Slaughter because of the high int. Global Silence is very good at dealing with Darkseer's combination plays. But they already have a Silence in Skywrath. Maybe it's overkill. I don't know. I could see it working, though.
Well, I've seen them do this before.
I think it could really work, actually. They have plenty of slows and stuns among their other heroes, and knowing Illidan or G, they like going Rod of Atos as well.
And there are not that many G heroes left, though.
No.
Not at all.
Storm Spirit?
Storm Spirit's playable. He's definitely playable this patch.
It's a great Storm game if you look at it. There's like no counters. Telekinesis is kind of annoying, but you can definitely play around that.
Yeah, I mean, if that's your biggest concern, it's a good game to
play.
That's
a good Storm game. It's for the same reason that it's a good Weaver game, basically. They kind of overlap in what they don't want to play against.
So running out of mid options, so many of them have been banned out. We're looking at like TA, DK, maybe even a Razor. There are just not that many good options.
Two of Viper are banned. Even? Only Razor and Viper remain out of those.
Oh, TA was banned last.
TA
okay.
And DK are banned.
Wow. Yeah. What do they have left? Alchemist, I suppose.
Alk is there? I don't think they want to pick Alk into Jug AA. That's. Oh, do you mean for newbie?
Newbie.
Ooh, alright. I like this a lot, actually. It's a melee core that can engage. Do you keep the Ion Shell on the... if you split?
I believe so.
You keep it on the green one if you split?
Mm-hmm, I think so.
Okay, that's really good then. Of course, it has to be careful with Skywrath Silence, but it's a great solution to playing against Slaughter in teamfights. Just throw him away.
Yeah.
Going back 2 years, Mu was actually considered one of the best
Brewmasters. The best Brewmasters. Yeah. I was looking at his most played. That's actually his fifth most played hero. Is he that great of a solution for Slaughter, though?
I think it's pretty good.
It's pretty good. I guess so. No, just not many teams have explored that option.
He's generally just very disruptive as well.
I think Silencer is the pick for Epino. It just got better, in my opinion.
What about a mid Lion?
I mean...
what about a mid Puck?
I would like it, but it's not...
yeah, Puck.
When's the last time we saw a mid Lion? 5 years ago? EHOME 2010?
ESWC 2010, never forget.
Yeah.
Weapon X.
If they pick Lion now, I'm gonna... I don't even know, Jacob. That would be amazing.
Oh,
so close.
Yeah, so far.
Interesting.
Also a Dota hero.
Indeed, a Dota hero. Thank you very much, gents. We are going to head over to our commentary team, who are very much waiting in the wings for their moment of glory to see whether Virtus Pro can make it through to the upper bracket of the main event. LD, it's all yours.
All right, welcome, guys. I'm LD, and of course, this is Purge. Hello, everybody. Kevin, what do you think of the Lion pick this game?
It's it roars instead of uses a Finger of Death, so I think it's very similar. It's a lockdown. It allows them to get solo kills. I really like the VP draft. I think it has way more dimensions to it. Lots of silences, disables, ways to initiate. Newbie is pretty much on the back of their Juggernaut in terms of carry potential.
All right. Well, He has had a very strong back before, as we heard. And of course, Hal had that ridiculous game earlier today on the jugs. But he's going to have his work cut out for him. I mean, there's so much control for that hero this game. It feels like the jug can't do it alone. Like, he's going to need the brew to set up the fights. And they don't really have any initiation until he gets a blink.
Yeah. The one really good thing about Brood in this game, though, is that the dispel on the Storm Panda has been buffed. It basically hits your whole team. And important things that can remove is any silence. It can remove amplified damage coming out of Slardar. It can basically give a lot of solutions to some of the damage sources coming out of Virtus Pro. So I think if he micros it really well, that could be something else that could potentially turn a couple team fights and win him a game.
Yeah, and it looks like he is going to get that 1v1 against a melee hero in the Beastmaster. So obviously this is where Brew historically excels, has the clap for the AoE slow and attack speed slow. He can trade right clicks really well, but the boars will be a bit annoying, I suppose. So we'll see early on VP. Very aggressive movement here from FNG. Had the boar to scout things out for him. Got a pretty deep ward down over towards mid. And Mu will now trot past that ward. Four heroes for newbie going top, and it looks like bottom. Hal wants to try and go for the double bounty grab here, but he will be forced back.
Yeah. Bounty goes to G. It'll be a fast bottle for him, most likely. I think he's going to have a decent time mid. G's doesn't play Beastmaster that often, but he did play Beastmaster a lot way back in, like, LGD Int days, kind of. That was the meta where Beastmaster mid was very, very popular, so I'm sure he's got it in him to play Beastmaster very well. We'll see him setting up a lot of kills, especially with heroes like Skywrath Mage, for example.
Yeah, that was a different time. That was when Shao 8 was probably the premier Beastmaster, and he wouldn't even skill the boar. Back then, you would just max out the passive. You just constantly push the lane with the axes. They'd have to last hit under tower. You'd get all the runes. There was only one rune back then, so it was a big deal to get it.
Yeah.
Times have definitely changed a bit. Might get the double boar.
Good D ward here by Chispug.
Two lane in some trouble here in the top lane. Actually, a flat cannon level 1 for Illidan. All right, never mind. Not in trouble.
A little weird. Oh, he's going to get really low here. Close. 57 HP. Yeah, decent start.
Why flat cannon level 1?
Is that just a miscue? Counter pushes the lane, therefore his creep wave, or their creep wave, is less likely to be under tower. So he doesn't have to last under tower. That's probably why he did it. Whereas Rocket Barrage would do almost nothing to a creep wave. Flat cannon does, like, you know, 150 physical per creep, so helps counteract the, you know, saves him HP, gives him last hits, all that good stuff.
That's a good point. Unfortunately, I guess in that case, maybe could have gotten the first blood otherwise, but...
Yeah, maybe.
Well, Darkseer is going to have to go back to base. He actually did use the salve, I believe, and then opted to go back anyway, so...
Yeah, that was a little weird. I mean, he's out of mana. He hasn't hit 2 yet, so VP's getting their job done, basically, and the pulling has begun.
Yeah, already Phobos, 2.5. I feel like nobody can shut down Slardar. This hero is like level 2 every game, almost off the bat.
He even went sprint level 1. His opponents didn't necessarily notice that, but it's something that potentially puts you in a dangerous position. So he could just pick up boots, basically, and just even roam and rotate on mid. That's somewhere that you could gank as well.
I've seen a bit of stacking here from FNG as he heads towards the top rune. The bottom rune going to be grabbed by Phobos, it looks like. So a double rune grab for VP off to a nice start there in terms of the control. And already, too late, he's abandoned the offlane. This is going to free up those VP supports, Kevin. And, you know, it's apparently for Fogged, a big Visage player, this is the ideal scenario. You just get to farm the stacks, pull the lane. You don't have to pressure anyone. You can just get that quick level 6.
Yeah, Lil played Visage one other time today, and he definitely made the space when he did get 6. He got a lot of kills. He ended up being like 5-1 and 6 around the mid game. Picked up a lot of major items and had a lot of impact with stuns and things like that with his birds. So I'm expecting him to see something, do something very similar here. Last time he went 2 grave chills, might adjust his build a bit since it's a Darkseer and can run fast. But for now, the chain pulls is going to be the name of his game. Get 6 as fast as possible.
Yeah, I imagine we'll see Tulay come back here at some point. But for now, it looks like he wants to stack. Does have the TP scroll if the lane pushes. But so far, it is not pushing, and FNG continues the stacking shenanigans. Another double stack created here. Something that Beastmaster or the Gyro could pretty easily farm up later on.
Probably Gyro, most likely, because most Beastmasters do max out the boar. They just want to be the most levels possible. That 40% slow is amazing, and giving more HP to your boar is a really big thing. So it'll have to be Gyro that kills it, and this will be also good because Gyro can shift, kill the stacks in the jungle, shift a little over, and get 6 even faster with that lane experience.
We're going to see the cliff, though. Phobos. That's a sad Slardar.
That sucks.
Let's see. Courier. It's already out, too. It's going to have to go all the way back.
And it's bottle growing, so even more delayed.
Oh, no. That donkey. He needs to lose some weight, man. He's slowly flapping his way back, but this is really going to irritate Phobos. Does buy the TP now. Chizpo goes to Hork on him from the low ground. It's slow going, but it's going right now. Does just barely have the vision from that ward.
He's got the misses. Five armor on Slaughter, man. That's why he's an offlane hero.
This is... Oh, that's a free bounty rune as well if he wants it.
We'll see. New bottle coming mids. I don't think the Brewmaster will rotate to this. I think he should just be... Yeah, he does pick it up.
It's like Phobos almost wants to die just so he can get back to this lane, which is currently pushing.
It's taking so long.
That's a lot of experience, and it's almost ideal for newbie that it is taking a while to kill him. How's still getting all the lane experience? I guess they're missing a pull here or there, but they want to push anyway.
I mean, Phobos could be getting experience right now. That's the unfortunate thing. But yeah, it's very good for how to push at this moment.
He can't even TP. He'll just get lifted.
Yeah. Goodbye.
Slowly and sadly, the Phobos will die.
Why would he use that? Why would you, Faithful?
Just to say, you know what, man? And you stick up the middle finger.
That's 120 mana. Like, that's... I don't know.
But Kevin, the satisfaction. Meanwhile, top lane, too late, almost dead, being dove aggressively here by Illidan. Doesn't have that salve that he blew earlier. Maybe could have saved his life here. Illidan just gonna walk away. The TP is there. Banana needs the body blocks under tower. He may die to rocket barrage.
Oh, barely gets
Illidan, but Illidan salves up. Almost survives. Not quite. Ooh. Meanwhile, mid lane. Looks like a brew split was committed, but not able to get anything done with it. Oh my god, action all over the place.
That's Illidan, man. He does some crazy stuff. A double kill there would have been amazing, but you know, Cold Feet has actually been a skill that's really prioritized again. It's not bad now. You cast it from farther away, and if the stun does set in, it's a mighty stun, as seen there.
Yeah, that was a big play too. Almost lived with the salve though. That would have been so devastating if they gave up the second kill.
Yeah,
we're gonna see Hal move around a lot. Early on, already level 6, wants to use this Omni Slash, but runs right by the creep wave mid. So it seems he's going to trot back towards bottom now.
Where's his target? He's got Skywrath Mage as an option, very low armor. He could maybe go for Visage, but Visage has got a skill and the Gravekeeper's Cloak, so maybe he's not an easy target either. It's really not a ton of solutions, but if he can find these kills, it's going
to
be a lot.
Man, they're already 5 minutes. I'm really surprised too late didn't go back bottom either, or back to top either.
Surely they're losing an experience, right? Yeah, they're diving pretty hard here. It's going in VP's advantage, but there was a spike up earlier. I mean, if they get kills out of this kind of a thing, then that's fine if they 5-man, but if they 5-man and nothing happens, they're losing a lot.
They are stacking, at least. That's something too late can quickly farm, and... Okay, finally someone's going to go top. It's the Rubik Chizbug who heads there, but it does feel like a lot of... And I wouldn't say waste of time because they did get the Slardar kill. It was a first blood, but since then, they're not really doing a whole lot with these supports.
Yeah.
It's going to be
tough to do stuff with the supports anyways because they've got Hawks in the jungle.
Hawks everywhere. Yeah, they're getting good vision right now. Keeping tabs on any rotations towards mid. Blink Dagger for Moose. Still a bit of a ways off here as execute the Hawk. More sure to come. What do you think for G? Is this going to be just an early Necro book kind of game?
Easily. Yeah, dude.
Is there any other build?
There's no other build right now. The Necro 3 build is just so good on Beastmaster. The attack speed bonus you give your Necros, you shred just about anyone. The only person they might have some trouble killing is going to be Brewmaster due to evasion. But they can definitely roar him and drain his mana, and then he can't ult.
Chizbug, you wanted experience. You can have it, but you're going to have to pay the piper. Lil, level 6 off of that at 7.5 minutes on a support visit. That is absurd.
Yeah. Very, very early pickup on his bats. He's sending him immediately mid. This could be where the gank goes. It's going to be a little hard. Oh, there's actually a smoke.
Yeah, G and FNG both rotating bottom. That's the Slardar.
Like
only level 3. DK Phobos has been the man who suffered the most, obviously, with the cliffing, but trying to get back into it now as the lane pushes. And newbie, they get cold feet. They back off.
Do they notice this happening? Do they smoke under the observer ward? There is a good observer ward on the mid lane. May have spotted them out.
I mean, generally you would smoke like over here, but I didn't actually see where they smoked.
That definitely reveals it. If Beastmaster denies the tower, it's like, okay, Beastmaster obviously in the bot lane.
I guess he gets the deny, but gank's over, folks. Well, still, they're keeping Banana out of experience range right now.
They're playing really safe. This looks like a team that is worried about losing the entire set, like really bad, and maybe overly so.
Instead of a team that's trying to win it, you know, it's like kind of that, oh shit, we're down one game, gotta be careful.
They're really fearing the Beastmaster gank. It hasn't happened, but even still, there's still a lot of CS on Beastmaster. 43 CS up for him.
They're doing okay in terms of the farm here, though. They are, have been consistently farming the stacks. It's more just there's certain heroes that are really struggling right now, like these newbie supports. Level 3 on the Rubick is being matched somewhat by the Slardar, though, so at least there's something there. We do see VP grouping up mid. Yet to really use the familiars, Kevin. And yet to really get that roar into play. We saw the exchange earlier mid, but didn't lead to any kills. Where should they be going first with this?
The mid is the safest place. He doesn't necessarily need to be there to cover. Look, he's basically using them in conjunction with other heroes. He puts them with FNG, and then FNG can do a gank. This alone could get a kill. Maybe not against a hero like Juggernaut, but he's trying to wrap around mid, actually. G in trouble.
Now, while that's happening, there's also a smoke gank in the jungle. Clap. Gets off the roar, though, on Moo, preventing the split. And FNG, who did smoke into this Radiant Woods, it has now been broken. The familiars, however, are still moving forward. And
oh, he's in
I
trouble.
Think,
maybe?
I don't think they saw him. Oh, actually, go, because he smoked past that ward. So I don't think they know he's here just yet, but they may find him soon. Pinging it out.
Are they going to go for this?
Familiar stun. One, two, gets the silence off. This could be a dead howl, very likely. Phase boots are available, but gets that next stun. Blade Fury is online. He's going to Blade Fury, dodges that nuke, and runs away.
Yeah, that's one reason I don't like this skill build on Skywrath Mage. They do kill familiar, bit of a loss there for Visage, but yeah, you get extra silence, but it really limits your damage potential. If he would have had 3 levels of Arcane Bolt, he might have been able to get 2 Arcane Bolts off before the silence ended.
Oh, Banana will take the concussive shot, but the Omni Slash executes and Howl just peeks out from the trees. Good grave chill from Lil. He'll back away. So he at least dodges away from Moo, but Moo wants that haste through, and he's going to get it. He'll be able to run down G with this, possibly get more. Pretty big overextension here from VP. Now Lil next on the list. The split's available. No, doesn't want to go for it.
What was G doing there, man? Was he just oblivious to the rest of the game? He's like, oh, wait, it's a haste rune. I'm going to get this. There's 3 heroes there, man. What are you doing?
Maybe he thought they were blind.
That was
very bold. Also, very unfortunate. That's like where you'd love to have Gyro in the fight, but he didn't have a TP cooldown, so Illidan couldn't join it.
Well, very peculiar little skirmish there. I kind of like what VP's going for here. This should be a Fizzbug kill, right?
Yep, that is the power of the Visage. Level 7. He's a carry, basically, at this point.
Yeah, it's got to go heal, but little ganks like that are very good. I like the movement that VP was doing, bats with a Skywrath Mage, giving pressure opportunities, but it just wasn't quite executed right, and then they got a little sloppy there and really brought newbie back in the game. It's a good way to make up for that EXP loss.
And they do push hard as well. We have to keep that in mind. They have the point in inner beast. They're close to the Necro Book, and they are grouping up mid lane. Do they want to go? No, seems like they'll back off now. And it's worth mentioning, Phobos has managed to catch up a bit. Level 6, yeah, a bit underleveled for Slardar, but at least he's got the amp damage now to help out the team. And they're going to make their move on top. They'll look for the tower. Blink is available now on Moo, though. This is the one thing with the Skywrath build, which I wanted to mention. Obviously worse for killing, but will be very nice against the Brewmaster if he's quick on the draw.
And especially if he sits at a point like 5 to 7 levels and doesn't really advance much past that, he's always going to be very good against the Brew. So against the Brew, sometimes you do have to do this kind of a build, but the same could be said if he got that kill on the Jug, for example. If he kills the Jug, use that extra level and put it into a silence to compensate. But it's hard to find that balance, and this is definitely the safer way to go, but it's the less possibility for him to just end the game with 15 kills, similar as the way that Lil was playing it earlier today.
I don't know if FNG is going to have a Lil level performance at this point. He's
possibly
0-1. But it's also partially the role, right, where he just doesn't get the same level of farm,
That's generally true.
So how is going to go Battle Fury on the Jung? This has increasingly become the build for Juggernaut players.
Yeah, I feel like the Mask of Madness, while it was the most overpowered item in the game, the 6.84 kind of a thing, or 6.83, whatever it was, 30% movement speed, 100 attack speed, very, very good, obviously. Oh, initiation coming.
They're going to jump onto Illidan here. They toss him up. They drop him down. He goes kablooey. As Howl will blade through the wave, and VP will pause. The Slardar has disconnected for a moment, but
that's the AA gank, man.
You know, Mask of Madness used to be so broken that Envy said he preferred it over a butterfly in one game.
Yeah, I remember that game. He was playing Sniper, and he was like...
And he's like, Mask of Madness was the correct 6-slot item. And I was like, you're right. It's better here. It's just crazy that a 6k gold item is this worse.
Is worse than that 2000. He's like, if I don't get attacked, why does it matter if I don't have evasion? I just want to attack really, really fast.
And the move speed. The move speed was ridiculous.
It's a 30% movement speed buff. Yeah, Flutter does that too, but it's only 6 seconds out of 30, whereas Mask of Madness has much more uptime. So, well, it's interesting to see the builds change. Basically, Battle Fury just lets you farm very rapidly because it gives you cleave, and it gives gives you bonus damage against neutrals. So while it makes you worse with that first 2,000 gold, once you get the 4K, it's going to translate you much better, and it covers you against a lot of bases like pushing creep waves and farming neutrals and against illusion heroes. It's all around a pretty good item.
Yeah, it's pretty good. We don't see it anymore, though. That item's gone the way of the dinosaur.
Oh, the Mask of Madness.
You know what else we don't see anymore? Dagon. Remember the Dagon pucks? The
saw
tinkers?
One today.
Did you?
Lil, playing it, when he was playing Skywrath Mage, he had a stupid amount of kills. First item, Dagon. Bronze Boots Dagon.
Man, I get all the worst games.
You did miss the 80-minute game.
Yeah. 80-minute Dagon game, yeah.
Well, he got a few other items. It was like Dagon, and then he's like, build an Atos.
What are you talking about? Lil doesn't get any items. Like, every scoreboard, he's just no inventory.
Yeah,
like,
mangoes usually. The six-slotted mango is his.
If he has the time, he goes for it.
Yeah, very common for him not to have items in that way. But I think the game's pretty equal. I feel like newbie's out rotating VP a little bit. They had some good momentum at the start, but then they kind of missed their little window for some ganks. They missed the kill on the Juggernaut, and then they lost a couple of kills here. They're losing the gyro right now is a really big deal because very likely lose their tier 1 tower. I guess it's pretty full HP. But 35 seconds, I don't know if that's going to be enough for Illidan to come back and defend this.
Not for long. With the Bruce play, they got the whole gang here. Yeah. This is... It's the stage of the game where it feels like newbie are just going to be stronger if they have the brew split up. Like, their overall team fight, at least. Whereas you look at VP, more of the pickoff lineup, more of the pushing lineup. Maybe they try to sneak Roshan. They are the physical DPS eventually, but
yeah,
they don't really have the farm quite yet.
Yeah, they don't quite yet. But I just feel like Brew is so good right now, especially against the VP lineup. Like, if they initiate on Brew, they're going to be in a really good spot because they can stun into Sounds, into another stun. He's going to die from that, almost for sure. But right now, if he gets the split off, you've got a 2-second stun on a 5-second cooldown, and he's basically just invulnerable. Late game, it's not going to be as good because Slark can, like, amp damage the various pandas. They can blow him up. But right now, it's a huge threat, especially with the AA. That was kind of the fixture of the first two games that they played earlier today, was that they would initiate. One person would always die because of Ice Blast. Didn't matter if they had Dazzle, didn't matter if they had a different hero. One hero always dies. And if you can pick the heroes and you initiate more properly than your enemies, then you're already at a 5v4 advantage. That's exactly what happened right now. And losing enemy carries, man, that's exactly who they wanted. There pretty much isn't a better pick.
Yeah, generally pretty bad to lose your carry, I would say, in my professional estimation.
It's a good call.
That's what they paid me for.
It's VP.
Looking relaxed, you know, maybe slightly bored, ready to play this one. And
yeah, she's like, I have less than 15 kills at this point. This game sucks.
Why didn't you pick me, Lina, Mr. Longhair Man?
Why did he grab... If he grabbed that haste, maybe he could have outplayed them all or something like that. But he was just... That's the worst feeling. You're like, I just need to get this rune. And then you don't get it. Ooh. That's a bad
and it
feeling.
was such a fight-changing rune, too. It's freaking haste rune.
Made a terrible mistake. Necro 1 is still pretty good, though. He can do a lot of mana burn. There's a lot of heroes that'll be good on.
And the worst part is now he's got to just contemplate his failure. That's like the worst time for it to pause. Right after you screw up, just pause. Think about how much you sucked in that last fight.
Yeah, that's tough. So if we can tell based on his screen that he is currently restarting Steam... It's like he'll be opening Dota. This is how
amazing.
We get our information.
Let's just lock onto his screen.
What a great
here.
Games library.
Can we get a close up of his profile here? You know, see how many hours he has played on Dota.
How
really
many Steam dollars does he currently have on his account?
How many do you think? What would be your guess?
Oh God, I don't know. That's a less than 400 US dollars. That's my guess.
As you can see, Dota is starting right now. It is loading in.
Yo, is there a camera shot of newbie? Have we seen newbie?
What's that?
I haven't even seen newbie on camera. Maybe I'm just not looking at the preview monitor at the right times. But
I don't think production finds some.
I guess it's all about VP right now, right? Because they're not in. All right, he's in. I can see his screen.
I think production's saying they're not as good looking. Is basically the reason there, Kevin.
I'm not going to comment on that one. All right, we're going to go back into it.
Listen, I didn't say it. We're back into it, guys. Welcome back. VP versus newbie. It is game number 2 with VP leading 1-0 in the best of 3.
They're going for it. Roar comes through.
Roar, how beautiful Mystic player.
Oh my god.
Drop, but my goodness, he melts.
That's their draft, man. Stun, Sky Mage, ult, and that's it. Dead.
All right. I'm pretty sure G feels a lot better now.
Yeah. The combo works so
They're
good
gonna
with
rush.
Visage, actually. That's amazing.
There's no brew split. This is like the perfect time to go rush, honestly.
You kill their carry? Okay, we'll kill your carry. Yep. Like, they must have felt so confident. Newbie's like, oh, we just got the carry. We're going to push. This is going to be great. It's dying pretty fast. Amp damage, man. And this damage aura, FNG finds.
Moving in, they do get aggressive. Screw not having the boost, but they still want to fight. They use the ion shell here, but Moo dives in.
What?
Is going to get focused, blown up, four down. And it's about to be five with Banana slowly
what
getting brought down by
happened?
Rocket Barrage. I cannot believe they went for that.
I mean,
no brew split, no juggernaut, no wall.
Right. You know what the issue was? That they just threw themselves at VP there. That ice blast didn't land on anybody, maybe put some debuffs down, but there wasn't any focus in that fight. They didn't lead with a stun. It was just brew hopping in. He threw the clap down, and all of a sudden VP's like, let's just use our spells, guys. And they just all died. Rocket Barrage.
I feel like
Soul
they had
Sumption
a death wish
the
there. That was like the worst time for newbie to fight.
It was definitely a weird situation.
Yeah.
Interesting Slar build. Four in sprint.
Oh. I guess he's feeling like he's not going to get the blink for a while, so he just wants that extra bit of mobility to get into the fights.
I mean, Slar's crush scale is really good around. It's actually amazing at a level 1 ability, 1.6 seconds of stun, so it's not terrible to go for this. I think you can definitely justify, like you said. It's a later blink, so it's more important that he gets positioned to be able to stun.
So, well, newbie, I mean, it's something that we talked about. It felt like they were a little nervous about losing, kind of playing reactionary Dota. Now they're pressing a bit. They need to buckle down here, Kevin. Is Howe is going to get scouted out top lane? And that is a pretty long silence. Can they get in range for the crush? Howe just blown up. Another death there for the carry player for newbie. Very unfortunate. And even with the ice blast attempting to turn that one, not able to do it. He's going Battle Fury, but it is being delayed significantly by these repeated deaths.
Yeah, that's so dangerous as well. It's their only carry potential, and he keeps getting killed. You know, VP has looked at this draft, and they'd say, all right, Brewmasters, you know, it's going to set up some kills on us, but the only thing we really have to worry about late game, other than maybe some vacuum AoE combos, is really Juggernaut being a hard carry. And they're set right now. Like, Illidan's farming very rapidly. Slardar's always going to provide amazing anti-carry, and they've got the disables from the other heroes. Are just going to set him up here. Moo in trouble, maybe.
He does have a split available, and well, they will manage to steal a very nice rocket barrage for Chizbug. Would have loved that call down, but he'll take what he can get. They're going to push on mid. Last time they did this, they just gave up one off the bat.
Roar's ready.
And he's just waiting for it. They'll show Illidan in front.
She just loves runes. He's like, I really like runes. Let me go get this.
Forget about my mid tower.
Yes.
Just give me that delicious bottle charge.
Surge coming in? No.
Okay. See ya. Concussive shot on Tule, and they're looking for it. They pop the Necro Book. Rubik warning them with the zap, but they're not going to go.
I like that. They maybe could have forced it with the Aegis here, but it was likely to be a bit of a weak trade. Played safe.
I feel like they can just kind of push in with the minions. You know, they don't really need to commit the heroes that much.
Here comes
Roar onto Howe. The follow-up could be there. The call down, they surge him, but it's Wall. He's Roared. Finally going to wear off. He Blade Fury's to dodge that Soul Assumption, and now the Ice Blast being chucked out. They will try to kill off the wave, but the Gyrocopter still finding kills on the backlight. Illidan going in ever so deep. They found two already. He wants another.
Oh, he gets stunned.
He will be held in position, but he still has the Aegis. Three down. Lil unveiling his visage to the disastrous results here. But now they look to turn it. They do manage to get off the Bruce split. Finding one kill. Moo in danger here, though. Phobos really wants to go back in. Almost as his Blake axes. Just a bit too late as he will jump away. It felt like it could have been even worse for newbie there, Kevin.
Yeah, no kidding. I was actually surprised that Illidan was on the back line getting kills because the initiation didn't quite strike home. They didn't kill the Jug initially, but he just came through the back line and he cleaned up those supports really easily, dealing a ton of damage. And with the Aegis, what do? They're like, what am I gonna use my 22-second disable or cooldown on telekinesis just to like delay Gyro killing me? It just. And the Brew went super deep on the back lane, but there was no damage to follow up. He distracted the rest of the team, but Gyro was strong enough to get kills on the back lane on his own will. So that was just really well done by VP. Tons of damage outputting on them, and newbie is just really lacking that at this point.
Yeah, now Phobos does have his blank. On top of that, the Necro 3 almost complete for G. That next big round of items coming out, potentially. Maybe we see the Sanj and Yasha for Illidan if he wants to build the Sanj. They're close to that next round, and they still have about a minute left on the Aegis, so we might see them try to push down mid again. For now, Lil making his way in. Tower will get denied mid for VP. More gold being taken away from newbie. And it is now a firm 5,000 gold, 7,500 experience advantage here as we crest past the 18-minute mark.
So FNG setting up for an eventual rotation of the top lane. He'll sit behind whatever cores here. G's got his Necro 3 ready. He's pretty much I can solo kill everybody. He's going to be really happy with this one. And the five-man continues for Newbie, who is behind. No Bruce Split for 20 seconds, though.
They're not even smoking. They're just five-man running top. And against the Hawk, against the Ward, they may get caught out. Moo! There's the Roar! Mystic player coming in, and he will get blown up. No, that was ugly. Now Newbie. Yeah, just kidding. We'll see you later, guys. But Phobos, he's got other concerns here. He wants to charge in. They drop the wall, call down deployed, and stole the level 2 Wild Axes. Not exactly ideal. They're still trying to fight. The Aegis is going to wear off here fairly soon, I believe, but doesn't even matter. Illidan just chewing through them. 4 dead. Feels like the Visage may have done even more there. And well, now the Aegis is gone.
Newbie is just getting completely run over. I thought last game was a bit of a fluke, and this game looked to be equal, but VP is just... there's nothing holding him back.
I feel like Newbie is just forcing it way too much in a lot of these fights. Like the Roche Pit, probably the biggest fight that they just had no business being there. And ever since then, they've been feeling desperate, basically, to take the fight to VP.
And I really feel like VP's draft is great. I mean, they might not have the most top-tier heroes. They've got Visage, they've got Skywrath Mage, they've got a Beastmaster. Three heroes that are pretty much forgotten in every other game, but it all fits together so well. Damage auras. I mean, the only really top-tier hero they have here is Slardar. You could make the same argument for Gyro, but those two heroes fit in with so many drafts, and VP really created something here that gives them so many kill options, and it makes the one core lineup of Newbie pretty much worthless.
And it really does show the versatility of G as he continues to play such a wide variety of heroes for the team. Now, VP taking down the tier 1 mid and swarming through the Radiant jungle. Aghanim's almost up on Lil. They are looking to push in this bottom lane, and how... I mean, where's the item progression, Kevin? He still is lacking the battle fear. He still doesn't even have the next component towards it.
He's had this for like 10 minutes
now. I know, this is just unbelievable.
He just hasn't got any Omni Slash kills, basically. Like, that's one of the ways that he went crazy earlier. He's like, oh, I'm going to get ridiculous items. He had 8 kills. That's because you have to get those Omni Slash kills while you're farming, while winning team fights, and that hasn't happened. He's just been focused and been forced to retreat before the fight even starts, and he's able to collect gold.
And he wants to leave the tower. VP planning the ward. They know what's up. Phobos is ready, but they get off the initiation here. Moo! Silence quickly by FNG, courtesy of the ward. He managed to get it off. Now the Ice Blast coming through. Lil starts to get in and go aggressive, though. Can Moo get off the split? Just barely he will. And suddenly it's VP who may have overextended. G going to be held in place there by the cold feet, and it looks like we'll go down to the Fire Panda. Double kill for Moo. It's not the biggest heroes to bring down, though. More utility and support, but Tule will be the third, the trade. And now the Brewmaster split going to be wearing off soon. He tries to run, he blinks out, but they have the up damage here, giving them a spot of vision as Moo scrambles back. At the same time, Banana is also amped off in the Radiant base. They're not going to pursue that one any further. Ample wear off, but Familiars continue pursuit. Looks like he should be able to get away. But in the end, the Brewmaster split committed, and it's still a 3-for-2. Looks like technically Newbie won the numbers game, but we'll see if they can be punched for using that Brew split.
Yeah, and FNG quickly realizes what happened there. Oh, they had an Observer Ward on the high ground, and that's why they saw me, and that's why the initiation wasn't quite perfect. Losing G, pretty big loss there, but by the time he's up and gets back to the mid lane, he's going to be ready to go again, and that's when Newbie is not going to have their Brew split. 60 seconds left on that one. If
all
they
right.
Don't have that, they're weak.
Hao has done it. He has his next component for the Battle Fury. The comeback is coming.
Still needs 1200 to finish it. And even then, it's frankly not a good Battle Fury game unless you get it at a point where it's going to accelerate your farm.
This is very much a game where you get the Battle Fury so you can get other items after the Battle Fury quicker. Not like, oh, I got a Battle Fury. Now I can actually take fights or have a big Omni Slash.
Yeah, the cool part about Jug is it's like, oh, I don't actually need a Battle Fury to get kills. So I'm going to get kills with my skills and then get a Battle Fury so I can also farm fast.
To
it's
pay
like,
the bills.
It's a, I didn't want to rhyme it quite that far, but...
I have no shame.
Okay, I see. So
I am a simple man. I hear rhyme opportunity. I mean,
two farming opportunities with your skills and with your items. So he's only got half of that, and he hasn't even accomplished that part. He's got to get the kills first.
I'm going to move into the Roche Pit now. Amp up on... Oh my god, look how quickly this guy dies. That is just gross.
The power of Slardar.
Are you surprised that Slardar gets through? Do you? Because a good example would be the Nunyun Championships, the Grand Finals. Banned 4 out of 5 games.
Yeah.
The one game he wasn't banned, Misery just like single-handedly crushed everyone.
I think he's probably the strongest here in the patch out of 4. I think he's first round bannable, but... Oh, fight happening.
Roar on Hao. They're going to try to take it. They have managed to steal that Roar, but can it make a difference here? Chizpok dies without even getting to cast a spell, basically. Beautiful ice blast. It's into the vacuum, and VPC, great. We're going to run it anyway. They simply don't care about the firepower that Newbie bring to bear. And they're going to even bring down the Earth Panda. Wow. GG, Newbie. Get brutalized here, and they will go down to the lower bracket. VP, they came to play today.
They really did, man. Had a great showing. They won a lot of games. It looked like they were pretty outclassed by EG, not massively, but moderately. And good victory for them, man. Winner's bracket already guarantees them a lot of prize money. They don't have to play BO1s, and that's got to feel amazing after Nanyang. They did the best, they had the most points out of all the teams there, and then they went and they got knocked out, like, instantly.
Yeah, they lost their BO3.